In the last video, we took a look at vertical asymptotes and described how we could use the limit notation along with the concept of infinity to kind of describe the behavior of functions that were rapidly approaching the top and bottom of the graph of a function. We're going to do almost the same thing this time, except we're going to talk about the behavior of a function on the left and right boundaries of a graph. So not only are we using limits to describe the behavior kind of in the middle of the graph, which is what we were doing at the beginning of our limit discussion, but we can also use it to talk about what's happening at the top, bottom, left, and right corners of the graph. So once again, let's pop over to GeoGebra. I'm looking at the same rational function that we started off looking at in the last video, which is y is equal to 3x plus 1 over x minus 2. So we've got the point, this point A, except that this time I want to see what's happening as A is moving off to the right. All right, and you can pay attention to the coordinates of the point over here. This might be a really good point to, really good place to keep your attention. So moving off here, I can see that our output value here is 3.35 right now. And as the x value is getting larger and larger, the y value is dropping 3.2, 3.11, 3.07. So it's getting lower and lower, but it doesn't look like it's going to negative infinity at all. It looks like it's locked there at 3.05, but as we go further out, 3.04, 3.03, it's getting really close to 3. Okay? And the same thing, let's look at the same thing as we head off to the left. So this time, now our x value is negative, our y value is 2.73 right now. And as we go further, 2.89, 2.94, 2.97. So once again, this time it's getting closer from below, but again, as we're heading off further and further to the left, it looks like our y value is getting closer and closer to 3 again. So let me draw this point, this line, y equals 3. And just like we had the vertical asymptote, which did a really good job of describing the behavior of the function near 2, this line y equals 3 is doing a really good job of capturing the left and right notion of the function. And so since we called the last line a vertical asymptote, let's go ahead and call this one a horizontal asymptote. And so now that we have this horizontal asymptote, we can also describe the behavior of this function using our limit notation. So think for a moment about how our limit notation is going to be different than it was when we were dealing with vertical asymptotes. So for vertical asymptotes, I might have said that the limit as x approaches 2 from the right-hand side of this function is equal to positive infinity, because as it's heading up this branch, it's getting higher and higher, it's getting closer and closer to the point where x is equal to 2, but it never reaches that point x equals 2 where it's undefined, and the output value just keeps on growing higher without bound. So that's why we were talking about infinity. This time, our heading off to infinity notion is happening with our x value instead of our y value. So see how the notation is different this time. This time, what I'm going to say is that the limit as x approaches infinity of 3x plus 1 over x minus 2 is equal to 3. All right, so as x gets higher and higher without bound, the value of this function is approaching 3. And we saw the exact same thing when we're heading off to the left. So in this case, the limit is approaching negative infinity, and the value of this function once again is approaching positive 3. Does that make sense? So in the vertical asymptote case, the infinity showed up on the right-hand side of the equation. When we're dealing with horizontal asymptotes, the infinity and the negative infinity are showing up as the limit of the x value. All right, I don't have a lot of extra stuff to say about horizontal asymptotes, but the idea, remember how we use tables to check the values of limits. We can do the same thing when we're approaching limits approaching infinity or negative infinity. So we would just, instead of having a sequence that's getting, say, closer and closer to zero from the positive side, that might be 1 over 10, 1 over 100, 1 over 1,000, 1 over a million is a sequence that's approaching zero from the positive side. To think of a limit that's approaching positive infinity, we might think of a sequence like 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, a million. That's a sequence that's not super rapidly approaching infinity because you never actually get close to infinity, but the behavior of the function should become clear when you're increasing at a rapid geometric pace like that. So once again, when we're looking at limits, we can investigate them using a graphing tool like GeoGebra or your graphing calculator, or we can use tables through something like Google Sheets, or once again, you can bring up a table on a graphing calculator. But the skill that we're going to need to steer towards is being able to evaluate these limits without using extraneous technology. For us to be able to just look at the function, maybe apply a little algebra to it, maybe apply a little common sense to it, and evaluate the limits from that perspective. So that's what we're going to be leaning into doing in the next couple of videos.